Okay, I'm going to show you how DC motor works. These two will represent the battery. The positive charge always has to be bigger than the negative. Arrows will represent the electrical current. And these two are the brushes to where the armature will wrap around. And this is the armature. These two represent the magnets. This will be the north pole. We need south pole. Okay, so how it works is that the electrical current will flow through this coil, go through these brushes to where it will be transferred to the armature. There, it will be going around the armature, and it will do the same thing backwards to the negative. So it will keep doing it. So we can also use the left hand rule to find out the way the force goes. So we put it over here. The middle finger always has to face towards the electrical current. It has to be facing the way electrical current will go. The index finger will represent the magnetic the magnetic force, which always has to go north to south. Some represent the force. So, put it aligned over here. The middle finger will always go with the current, as the arrows are showing. So, go this way. The force so far will now be facing going towards us. From north to south, the index finger will show.
Gabe, I need you to stay
on this other side. Underneath, it would have to be the other way around. The force would be going away from us. The next finger will always have to go from north to south. So that's how it works. And then we can use the right hand rule, which you just do a thumbs up. The thumb will be the current. Fingers wrapped around your thumb in a magnetic field. It'll represent how the magnetic field, which way it goes wrapped around the watch. Oil and electric current. If you put it here, we'll have to go.
This picture right here.
So let's see the tail. It's going to wrap around that way. Down here, we'll do like a thumbs down. The magnetic field will be wrapping around it away from us. That's how a DC motor will work. So, thank you for watching.